Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a beloved star in film, television, and stage, long considered as one of Hollywood's most iconic working actors.
In his latest role, he plays the patriarch in the new TV series, Culweber's The Family Business. Take a look.
You are going to get my son killed over a drug. What's happened to you, LC?
I'm the same man I've always been, Charlotte. Let's not forget it was you who brought me into this drug business in the first place.
We don't need a new drug. We have enough money, honey. When is enough gonna be enough?
When my children and grandchildren are in the White House.
Oh, ooh, I can't wait for that. Please welcome the amazing Ernie Hudson. Yes! Yes!
Hello, sir. How are you?
That's right.
I'm
That's
so good.
Right.
Oh.
Okay. Even Luther said never too much, baby. That's what he said.
Boy, I tell you, Mr. Hudson, you just look amazing.
Yes, you
well,
do.
You.
I say you're looking
thank
like
you.
A bomb.
Well, when people say that, they always seem surprised. I'm not quite sure, but thank you.
Well, I'm not surprised, because you know black don't quack. But what is your secret to staying this youthful looking and vibrant and working? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've been very, very blessed to continue working. Mm-hmm. I think for me, it's just giving up on trying to get stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And just allow things to happen and to just get into, you know, giving and receiving and giving thanks.
Mm. Oh, that's right.
But what do you think it takes to have staying power in this business?
Mm-hmm.
I think for me, the one gift I got from my grandmother was just, you know, the belief in God as a presence that is there for me, that doesn't qualify me if I'm good or bad or whatever. It's always there.
Mm.
And having faith in it as opposed to people or the industry or anything else, other than I know that there's an answer and it's coming.
Mm-hmm. And you're really a walking, talking success story. I mean, you grew up misfortune and you still went to Yale College.
Yeah.
And still have been able to have an amazing, successful movie and television career.
Right.
And the word on the street is, when you had your first day in Hollywood, you were booked.
Yeah, yeah. Once again, I know that there's an answer. I know the answer is coming.
Yes.
I just don't have to know where it's coming from, but I trust that it'll be there, and it always has been.
Look at God.
And coming from adversity or whatever you want to call it, it's just life. I mean, we're just living. So I can look back now, and people judge it that way. But for me, I've lived a charmed life.
Mm-hmm.
I've been very blessed.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Speaking of which, you know, one of my favorite movies, I have to be honest, is Hand That Rocks the Cradle.
Okay,
can take that
yes.
Solomon. Oh, you're amazing.
Anyway, Solomon, yes.
I don't want to veer too far off, but you've been, let's see, Ghostbusters, 35 years now?
Yeah,
good
35
God
years.
Almighty. It doesn't really seem that long.
Well, in some ways, it seems like yesterday. In other ways, it seems like it's been forever. But yeah, all good years. And yeah, people grew up watching it. Now their kids are watching it. And they saw it for the first time with their parents. And so it's a wonderful, it crosses generations.
Uh-huh.
And I just feel very blessed to have been a part of that.
Were you about to?
I was going to ask, like, how do you feel like Ghostbusters has changed your career?
Well, it changed my career in the sense that it forced me to grow up because it was none of the things that I thought it was going to be. I thought if you're in a big hit, the world opens up, and the world, it does open up, but not in the way that you think.
Right.
So
right.
I had to go, let's get real. Let's know that it's a long road, and, you know, it hasn't been any overnight success.
Right.
You know, it's been a journey, but a wonderful journey, but a journey.
Let me ask you this really quickly. From the time of Ghostbusters, do you think that the industry, how do you see that the industry has changed for black actors and actresses up until now?
Well, it was a slow change. Mm. There was a time when it seemed like I was the only one working.
Mm.
But I will say, recently, in the last few years, I mean, things have opened up in ways that I could only dream of.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, seriously, on our show, The Family Business, I think 70% of the people working on the show are women
wow.
of color.
Right.
I mean, it's, yeah, parts. The role of Elsie Duncan, I dreamed of playing a role like this. I've worked a lot, but in other people's movies, other people's stories, this is a story about a black family. I mean, that's hugely different for me. So I'm, it's changed. And I think we need to embrace the change and hold on to that as opposed to focusing on how it hasn't changed.
Right, right. Ooh. Yes.
Well, we're going to talk more about family business with Mr. Ernie Hudson in just a moment. Plus, director Trey Haley's going to join us, so just stay right here with us.
We are back with a very talented Ernie Hudson, and alongside him, we have the pleasure of the director of family business, Trey Haley.
Hey. Welcome.
This is an amazing pleasure to have the director of the actual series. So, Trey, tell us about the cast and the dynamics of the cast.
Yeah, this cast is great. You know, we put an ensemble, a cast of a lot of different age ranges here, a lot of different styles and flavor. Obviously, we started with patriarch himself, Ernie Hudson. We brought in Valerie Pettiford. We also have people like Javicia Leslie, who you know you see on a lot of new shows, our new up and coming actors. So we like to blend it, even bringing in Christian Keys and Darren Henson, Sean Ringo. I mean, everybody's just on different things. And so we also have, it's a very multicultural cast. You know, we have Emilio Rivera and Armand Asante coming in to do things at the very beginning. So, you know, we have the Latin cartel, we got the mafia.
It's dope.
I mean, we got a little bit of everything.
Yes.
We have one of our beautiful cast members who's going to be here this morning with these guys.
Absolutely. Braylee Evans is in this as well. And Braylee, man, she brings it on this next episode. Y'all got to check this one out.
Very excited to talk to her. But this series is based on a book series from Carl Weber.
Yes.
So tell us why this project attracted to you.
Yes. Well, basically, we've worked with Carl on a series of films. You know, we started with The Man in 3B, and then we went on to do The Preacher's Son, choir director, and now we're doing this. So it's kind of like the family business is his number one book of all his books.
Right.
Carl is a 27 times New York Times bestseller.
I know that's right.
And so this one was his baby, and we just really were excited to do this, and he said, hey, let's take this on. We first shot it as a film, being proactive and just putting it out there, knowing that this was a book series. And then BET came along, saw what the potential was of this when they saw it, and they said, hey, let's break this thing up into 8 episodes.
Nice.
And so it kind of went from there.
And Ernie, I mean, you've been in the industry for over 4 decades. Is there anything left that you want to do?
Well, I think I'm doing it now. I'm sort of living my best life. I'm having a good time, you know. So, no, it's been really great. And I've been sort of fighting against all these stereotypes about black men. So this is about family, and the being the patriarch of this family is just wonderful.
Oh. And we're so thankful that you guys are showing black men in an amazing light.
Awesome.
And thank you so much. Don't forget to catch Carl Weber's The Family Business Tuesday nights at 9, 8 Central on BET. And the conversation always continues at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.